today's topic is electric traction and brief history of Indian railways and important terms. There were Indian merchants both in Calcutta and Bombay who took an interest in funding of the railways. The most prominent of these was a remarkable Bengali merchant, Prince Dwarakanath Tagore, grandfather of Nobel laureate poet Rabindranath Tagore. Dwarakanath's firm called Tagore and Company is reported to have offered in 1844 to raise one third of the capital required for a railway from Calcutta northwest to the coal fields above Burdwan. The railway age dawned in India on 16th April 1853 when the first train ran from Bombay to Thane, a distance of 21 miles, that is 33.81 kilometers. The first proposal for construction of railways in India were presented in 1844 to East India Company in London by two companies. One is East Indian Railway Company headed by R. Macdonald Stephenson, and number two, Great Indian Peninsula Railway Company. Both East Indian Railway Company and Great Indian Peninsula Company were incorporated in England for the purpose of constructing railway lines in Calcutta and Bombay presidencies respectively. Though Great Indian Peninsula Railway Company was formed in 1844, George Stephenson could not see his locomotives run on Indian soils as he died in 1848. Stephenson was a pioneering railway engineer and inventor of the rocket, the most famous early railway locomotive. Inventor of locomotive, George Stephenson. George Stephenson was born on 9th June 1781 in England. His father was an engine man at a coal mine. Stephenson himself worked at the coal mine and learned to read and write in his spare time. In 1814, Stephenson constructed his first locomotive, Bulcher, for hauling a coal at Killingworth Colliery near Newcastle. In 1815, he invented a safety lamp for use in coal mines, nicknamed the Cordae. In 1821, Stephenson was appointed engineer for the construction of the Stockton and Darlington Railway. It opened in 1825 and was the first public railway. In October 1829, the railway's owners staged a competition at Rainhill to find the best kind of locomotive to pull heavy loads over long distances. Thousands came to watch. Stephenson locomotive Rocket was the winner, achieving a record speed of 36 miles per hour. Stephenson became an engineer on a number of these projects and was also consulted on the development of railways in Belgium and Spain. Stephenson died on 12th August 1848. His only son, Robert, was also a railway engineer and worked with his father on many of his projects. Important terms in electric traction. The word traction is also used in medical science, a way of treating broken bones in which a device gently pulls the bones back into place. It is a meaning of traction in medical science. What is meant by electric traction? It means locomotion, the power or ability to move in which the driving or tractive force is obtained from electric motors. What is meant by traction? The adhesive friction between a wheel and a surface, as between a driving wheel of a motor vehicle and the road. What is meant by adhesive? A substance that unites or bonds surfaces together is called as adhesive. Define friction. A force that resists the relative motion or tendency to such a motion of two bodies or substances in contact is called friction. Define adhesive friction. The friction between a body and the surface on which it moves, as between an automobile tire and the road. Define force. We know it very well. A force is a push or pull acting upon an object as a result of its interaction with another object. There are different type of forces. A force is a vector quantity. What is meant by tractive force? Tractive force is the force used to generate motion between a body and a tangential surface through the use of dry friction, though the use of shear forces of the surface is also commonly used. What is meant by dry friction? Dry friction resists relative lateral motion of two solid surfaces in contact. Dry friction is subdivided into static friction between non-moving surfaces and kinetic friction between moving surfaces. What is meant by shearing forces? Shearing forces are unaligned forces pushing one part of a body in one direction and another part of the body in the opposite direction. When the forces are aligned into each other, they are called compression forces. Now we will see the mechanics of train movement. Mechanics of train movement. The driving parts of an electric locomotive consist of pinion and gear meshed with the motor as well as with the wheel. Here, this is a locomotive wheel. Its diameter is capital D. This is a gear wheel. Its diameter is small d. This is a pinion. Its diameter is D1. This is a motor armature. Here, the tractive effort is a vector quantity. There are three forces. One is force required for the motion of the train. Number two, force against gravity. Number three, force against friction. The torque produced by the motor is transmitted to the wheels through the pinion and gear. This is the arrangement. Therefore, torque developed by the motor MRT is equal to F1. F1 is the force working on the edge of the pinion into D1. D1 is the diameter of the pinion divided by 2. Therefore, F1 is equal to 2 into T divided by small D1. Therefore, tractive force transmitted to the locomotive wheel is equal to alpha into F1 into D divided by capital D. Now, small d is the diameter of the gear wheel. And capital D is the locomotion wheel, that is capital D. And we know that F1 is equal to 2 into T divided by D1. Alpha is the efficiency of transmission. Therefore, Ft, tractive force, is equal to alpha into 2 into T divided by D1, this is 2 into T divided by D1, into D by capital D. That is equal to alpha into 2 into D divided by capital D into D divided by D1. You can rewrite D by D1 is equal to beta is the gear ratio, where D is the diameter of the gear, D capital D is the diameter of the locomotive wheel, D1 is the diameter of the pinion. Therefore, tractive force Ft is equal to alpha into beta into 2 into T divided by capital D.